Okay, guys. BA11, Chapter 14. Chapter 14, Exploring Media and E-Business. Social Media and E-Business. Sponsored by Brooklyn Body Gear, the best underwear money can buy. And, of course, my company. We're going to be talking about that. Okay, we're going to do Chapter 14 first before I do Chapter 11, which is the marketing chapter. I want to spend as much time as I could on the marketing chapter for you. But of course, anything you need to know in the marketing chapter, chapter 11, you have a bunch of other videos from my other class. But let's do chapter 14 first. Exploring media and e-business. BA11 fundamentals of business. Let's start. Okay. Why it's important to the business to use social media. Why are we even have this question? Okay, let's start. Why is social media important? Social media, online interactions that allow people in business to communicate, sharing ideas, personal information. We know this already. Every business has a social media presence. Every business on the web. Every business can be found there. Imagine if you went to a store, went to a shop, and you asked if they have a website. Unless it's some old mom-and-pop operation in the middle of nowhere, I would imagine that every single business would have a website and some kind of social media presence, okay? Brooklyn Body Gear, that's all we're doing. All e-commerce. We're not going to be selling in stores. Everything is on social media. Hopefully through social media, we can create some kind of buzz for the company. Maybe YouTube. Who knows? So, why is social media important? Obviously, people are more involved now, especially during this coronavirus. Everybody's on social media 24/7 now. Okay, development of social media. Okay, it all started in 1991, AOL, and then we had Napster. I remember Napster in those days. Wikipedia, then LinkedIn. Okay, and then 2007, then the Apple App Store. And then before Facebook, remember there was this MySpace. So we all know the development of social media. And if you don't know the development, it doesn't really matter. Stuff that happened back then, it's like an anachronism now. Anybody that's a Foursquare mayor of Foursquare, it's like being in MySpace, okay, which is nothing now. Okay? Why businesses use social media? Mainly to engage with customers. Okay, if you watch chapter 3 in BA14 on YouTube, which I recorded yesterday, we talk all about how social media and through any kind of social, any kind of online media, you will be engaging the customers. Okay, exciting the customers, engaging customers. Okay. Increase exposure, most important benefits, exposure for the business, increase traffic, and develop the fans. Remember, it's all about engaging the customers through social media, okay? That's what I'm trying to do here with Brooklyn Body Gear, is trying to engage the companies, engage and excite the customers about my brand and the idea about my brand, okay? And it can generate leads and improve some search rankings, okay? Business use, social content. Sites, talk about products and services. So some sites are blogs and videos and podcasts, but the main thing is these blogs. Remember, when it comes to blogs, from a business aspect, okay, you're going to pay these people to write about the blogs. From a customer aspect, understand that these blogs, someone is paying someone for these recommendations. So it's really not going to be unbiased as you may think. Oh, I really love this underwear. I really love this Brooklyn Body Gear underwear. It's the best underwear money can buy. If I wrote the blog, I own the company. So that, you know, obviously it wouldn't be necessarily so unbiased, okay? And even other companies that say, oh, we're underwear connoisseurs or something. Let's say we underwear connoisseurs. I might actually pay them to say that my brand is very good. So you never really know from a customer aspect, but from a business aspect, these bloggers might actually help you build your business, okay? Social content sites, and of course videos on YouTube. On this YouTube, I should be putting stuff about me running around in my underwear or any other companies You see on YouTube, there's always these videos, which of course help experience and help customers get engaged. Okay, a blog, website, increase the company's knowledge, build better relationships with the customers, and you can attract new customers with it. Okay, most companies do have a blog. I wonder really how many people read these blogs, but if I'm looking into something that's really very sophisticated, maybe a car, if I was going to go buy a Porsche, I used to own a Porsche, I would go on a blog just to read about it. It doesn't really matter what they think or if they're getting paid by Porsche, but especially if it's an old Porsche, which is what I used to have, a vintage Porsche, these bloggers might be talking about vintage Porsches. I don't know if they're necessarily going to get paid. So you can really pretty much tell who is being paid and who's not being paid. But it's really to educate the customer. So website allows a company to increase the knowledge. But for my company, let's say, for something like this, I might have a blogger that would write about underwear and about the feeling of it, or the, you know, how it feels, moisture wicking and all of that stuff. Okay, it builds better relationship with customers and attracts new customers. And telling the stories about the company. Remember, you're trying to create some kind of feeling for the company, some kind of attachment for the customer with the company. And that is the idea. Okay, it's really not about selling as much as it's about trying to create some kind of loyalty and some kind of relationship. Okay? Media sharing sites. What's a media sharing site? Instagram should be considered a media sharing site. YouTube's media sharing, okay? Social network sites, Facebook, YouTube. Once again, Chapter 3, if you want to go for BA14 Chapter 3, there's more about this. But remember, we're going to try to do just the basics in this class. Okay, podcast, digital audio that people listen to and watch, or watch online, but podcast really listening, okay? I am a big film noir freak. I love old film noir, so I try to listen to podcasts related to film noir, and I actually have an idea of doing my own podcast for film noir. Not that I'm an expert, but maybe I will bring some experts on, but I do love film noir, and I don't know where I'm going to find the time when I'm too busy making videos for you guys. Okay, so social media rankings. Social media ratings. The main thing about social media is that customers are going to come and look at social media. The first thing they're going to do to check out your brand, they're going to check your social media presence. Okay, I'm sure for Brooklyn Body Gear, they first see about my company just from Instagram and from Facebook. Okay, and then maybe I will get them to the website. But they're going to look for opinions, recommendations, referrals through social media. And when we talk about e-commerce, through that as well. When my company becomes bigger, they're going to talk about it, and that's really the idea through social media ratings. Okay? Social game, forget social games. Social media communities, remember, there's forums. There's all kinds of forums. Like I said, when I used to have my vintage Porsche, I used to go to a Porsche forum to talk all about that particular car. Usually, the bigger the company, the more forums there are. Interactive community bulletin board, and it's threaded discussions. There might be something about men's underwear, but really it's mainly for cars and for stuff that's really maybe computers and stuff like that. You all know what forums are. Forget this wiki. Okay, top 7 social media networking. I gotta tell you, there's no more Google Plus really. This is very old, 2015. Things change with social media very quickly. There's no Snapchat here, as you can see. There is no Instagram here. We know Instagram is probably here now, right? Most popular, 94%. I wonder, Facebook is probably really for older people now. Snapchat, TikTok, I mean, it's not even on here. So that's the great thing about using, why I like to use these old, these older slides from old editions, because this way you can actually see how quickly things are changing in business right now, okay? 5 years, from 2015 to 2020, 5 years, look how much changed. There's no more Google+. Pinterest, okay, still out there. Some blogging, YouTube is even higher this now. This Facebook is probably lower now, really. Instagram, Snapchat, even TikTok is working its way up. This is the proof why I use these old videos, why I use these old slides. Not because I can't get new ones. I use the old slides to show you, look how things change in business. Everything changes so quickly, and this is just social media. So you can imagine, a few years ago, Foursquare was very big. I don't even know who uses Foursquare anymore. So keep that in mind, how things change so quickly in business, okay? Reputation management, that's another thing. Through social media, you can do a lot of PR work. Remember, if there's a crisis, you can figure it out. Sentiment analysis, what is going on through social media. There's a company known as Diva Curl. They are a curly hair company. They make products for curly hair. Right now, what is going on now, I don't know, hopefully you'll be watching these videos in years from now and there won't even be anything to talk about. But right at this moment, there's a whole social media campaign about how it is not good. Supposedly their hair falls out by using their products. Whether it's true or not, that's another story. I don't believe it's true. Maybe people didn't use the products right or whatever. The point is they are now doing some crisis management through social media. Okay, and using social media and through conversations to try to figure out what's going on, okay? Listening to the stakeholders. What are stakeholders? We talked about this in chapter one. What are stakeholders? Everybody has a stake in the company. Everybody that's involved. Who are the stakeholders for Starbucks? We talked about the landlords, the customers, the growers of the beans, the people who pick the beans. Everybody that has a stake, the landlords, the people who make the furniture, the cup guys, okay? Who are the stakeholders? So listening to what the stakeholders are talking about that particular company. Okay, to help understand what people think. Once again, sentiment analysis. You want to get deeper into this? Chapter 3 on my YouTube for BA14. Okay? Millennials, tech savvy, individuals born after 1980, targeting customers. Okay, social media marketing, using social media tools. I have this mosquito. One second, I gotta get this guy. I hope I got him. Okay, it was just getting me, it was annoying me. Okay. That's what happens when you shoot live. Okay. Social media marketing. Utilization, social media technologies, okay? All I do is social media marketing, okay? Using social media, whether you're going to do ads on social media or you're just trying to engage the customers through social media, okay? To create, communicate, deliver, and exchange offerings that have value for the organization. I give away underwear. You see videos, everything related to getting the customer engaged and getting them interested in your product, okay? To get inbound marketing, get any new product ideas. Crowdsourcing. What is crowdsourcing? Going as outsourcing tests to a group of people to tap their ideas. You might go to a bunch of people and say, what is your idea? A great place to do crowdsourcing, which I do, is through Facebook. I go do crowdsourcing on Facebook or crowdsourcing on Instagram with my friends and other people and say, hey, here's the question. What kind of fabric do you like? I did some crowdsourcing to actually figure out which fabric people like for the underwear. And the underwear that I use a rayon fabric, which is not a cotton fabric. It is a nice silky fabric because I figured out through crowdsourcing that people like this particular fabric over basic cotton. Okay? Especially the younger people. So, generating a project idea through crowdsourcing. Okay? Recruiting employees through LinkedIn. Social network, LinkedIn through for business. Everybody, guys, every one of you should have a LinkedIn account. I don't care if you have no job or no nothing. At least put your education. Start with a LinkedIn account, okay? Largest social network for professionals, saves time, lower recruiting costs. I got a bunch of interviews through LinkedIn when I was in marketing. So you should have LinkedIn, okay? Develop a social media plan, okay? Once again, we're not gonna go so deep here because it's just basic. You can go to my chapter 3 video for BA14, which is my marketing class, and you can learn more about it. But pretty much a social media plan. Understand what you want to do, what your budget's going to be, what are your objectives. Always what the objectives are, okay? Select your social media customer. Figure out what your customers use the social media tools. Remember, this is going from marketing. Of course, it's chapter 14, chapter 11, or chapter 3. What is it? Chapter 11 is the chapter is a chapter for marketing. So this is after. But understand, develop a social media thing through your marketing plan. Okay. So types of information that can help different social media customers gather information. Identifying, remember, there's all, once again, sentiment analysis. What are people saying on social media? What are they saying about your product? Watching what people are saying. The main thing that you have to understand is that many companies just have people sit in front of social media all day long, watching and listening to what people are saying, what their preferences is, what their attitudes, what are the good, what are the bad. And from there, they can change their products and they can listen, analyze, and do. They can listen what's going on, analyze what's going on, and then they can make changes based on that. Okay? Forget this for now. This is a little too deep for this particular class. Okay? So remember. When it comes to social media, and it comes to even your website, remember, how many unique visitors do you have? How many number of views, number of followers, okay? Number of likes for Facebook. Okay, number of views, number of videos, and number of visitors. How many people? I wonder how many people are watching my YouTube. I wonder if smacking this mosquito is going to make this go viral. I wonder. Okay, click through rate. How many people are going through it? Once again, if you want to go deeper into it, is chapter 3. Okay, but understand just the basics here. Okay. Sentiment analysis, we discussed this, okay? Categorize what is being said about the company. Customer satisfaction, okay? Once again, attitudes and preferences, okay? The cost of maintaining. It costs both time and money. Believe me, I have my interns as well as myself spending time figuring out how to do a social media plan, okay? What's working, what's not working, what are we going to change? And it has to constantly adapt. The control phase. Okay? Re-evaluate, re-analyze, and fix things constantly. It has to be constant, especially now. People have a short attention span. Things change all the time. If something's not working, you can change it very quickly. Much different than a regular advertising plan from beforehand. Okay? You put a magazine ad. Maybe you had to do it 6 months before. Here, you can change your social media on a daily basis. This is working, this is not working. You can change it every day. And you should always have someone working only on social media that focuses on that particular aspect of your company. And maybe you can be that social media person. Okay? E-business. Obviously, organization efforts, selling products online. Okay? We already know. Through this COVID, nobody's going out, or you shouldn't be going out. Everybody's buying online. Amazon is exploding. We all know this. And probably, in going forward, this is... this COVID, even though we knew this was happening in reference to retail, I think this is the death knell for the actual brick and mortar stores. Yes, people are going to still want to go and have the shopping experience, but I think it's definitely not going to be the same, and it's just what I read is that it's just going to accelerate the process. So instead of it being in 5 or 10 years where it's going to be less, it's probably going to be 2 or 3 years. Okay, that is my opinion as well. Once people get used to being home, and who knows how long this is going to be, maybe September, October, people are going to start going out. But even if they start going out, they're not going to want to be in crowds. The days, I can't even imagine. I mean, maybe I could. I don't know. I'll have to see what happens in November. But I can't even imagine waiting online before Black Friday and everybody going in together. Okay? The whole social distancing thing. I don't even want to be next to anyone, I would think. Okay, unless they have a vaccine, and even if they have a vaccine, I don't know if I want to be next to anyone. So who knows how this is going to change. So everything is not going to be e-business and mobile marketing. The biggest thing, everybody has a phone. You may not have a laptop, but you have a phone, even in the middle of nowhere. Okay, I was just in Egypt, and in the middle of the desert, camels and cell phones. That's what they had. So mobile marketing is the way to actually engage the customers through mobile devices, okay? Combining the resources, remember, human resources, material resources, informational resources, financial resources, we talked about this already many times, okay? Human resources, website designers, material resources, computer software, informational resources, customer tracking systems, order fulfillment, right? Any kind of computer and information resources for that, and of course financial resources, any of the money that's involved. So this is just the e-business resources, no different than regular business resources. Okay? Okay, satisfy the business online, okay? Create the customer needs. So remember, you can get more information no matter what website you go to now, especially now during this COVID. They're always giving, you know, try something new, free, you know, freemium, where they're going to give you something free first before they want you to, before they let you buy it. But the first thing is they'll always, you have to put your, you're always going to have to put your email in and your information in, because that's a good way for them to keep sending you more and more information. And of course, getting information about you, okay? That's another whole thing that we speak about in marketing, okay? Okay, revenue stream, e-business profit is no different than any other profit, right? Okay, revenue minus expenses equals profit, okay? Okay, the business model is no different than any other business model, okay? It's the same thing, generate revenue, reduce expenses, the B2B, B2C, we talked about this already, okay? Business to business, business to consumer. The good thing about e-commerce is that you don't necessarily need a physical location. You can do it out of your house. I'm doing Brooklyn Body Gear right out of this apartment, and through Amazon, okay? I still spent a lot of money, but nowhere near as much if I had to have a shop or I had to have a warehouse, okay? So you can actually save some money in doing e-business, okay? Planning a new internet business, no different than starting any other business, okay? Creating an online presence, like I said, this is just a very, very basic class, but it's no different than starting any other business. With a business, you have to, you know, figure out, of course, have someone design a website and create a name and make sure the name is not taken, and then, of course, make sure that the social media is not taken. All of this has to be done strategically, of course, okay? Business models, once again, what is your model going to be used? You're going to do a business-to-business model, which means you're going to sell only to other businesses, or you're going to sell to consumers, okay, or both, okay? Okay, internet growth potential, we already know about this, which is why, like I said, I love using old slides, because it's just funny. About 3 billion people in the world, maybe what is it now? A bazillion, probably every single person, right? Okay? Internet new frontier. This is like, it's like reading an old newspaper, right? New frontier. Okay. Understand this about cookies and data mining. Okay. So remember, cookies, little tracking thing that go on the computer. You already know there's data mining. Anything know about data mining? There's so much data out there. They need a place to keep it. They keep it in a data warehouse. Data mining, you go through this and analyze that. That's all I ever did when I was in work, is analyze. First of practice of searching through data records, getting information, analyzing that information, and be able to make changes to your business model based on what you find through data mining. Of course, when you take my marketing class, or you go online and watch my marketing videos, we do a whole thing about data mining. And that's in chapter 10, which is the marketing research chapter, okay? Ethical and legal concerns. The main thing is, like I said, maybe people don't think it's so ethical to do the cookies. I think it's a great idea, and like I said, we'll talk about more about this in my marketing videos. But the main thing about cookies that I'm going to say is that it's sent by the website to track you. But the main thing about cookies is that they're going to track you to see where you go, and from there, then they can target ads for you. Okay, from a business aspect, it's a great thing, because now you're getting a customer that's actually excited about that particular product. And you're not going to send it to the person, you're not going to send an ad or some kind of deal or some kind of Groupon or something to someone that is not interested or never looked for that particular product. Okay? Internet crime, malware. We all know what's going on with spammers today. They put something in your computer and then they hold you for ransom. Okay? Future challenges, there's cloud computing. We know this, the cloud is a place that you can keep all your information. There are some laptops today that don't even have any hard drive. Everything is kept in the cloud. Maybe I'm just too old for it. I like everything on my flash drive or on a hard drive, but that's me. Everybody has a different idea of what keep stuff in the cloud, but I guess my website is kept in the cloud. What affects internal and external forces, okay, no different than when I talk about it in marketing. So remember, there's demographics, there's societal, CD step, if you take my marketing class, chapter 5, CD step, and same type of issues, political issues, legal issues, technology issues, competition, the economic issues, okay, and internal forces, the financing, management decisions, human resources, okay. E-business is no different than any other business, okay? Green IT, forget that. Guys, this is a pretty easy chapter. Pretty easy chapter. So, from here, you're going to watch chapter 11 first. That's going to be the main thing. Guys, I love you all. Easy chapter, you already know this stuff, and hopefully this is actually the last chapter for this class. I hope you liked it. I hope you take my other class. And remember, BA11, BA14, BA31, CUNY, Morris Didia. Guys, I love you.